What do you think? I think it turned out pretty good. All right, next we are going to make one of these. If I can remember how. Might have to watch my own tutorial. I've got my notes here, so. First of all, you'll need 17 pieces of paper. 6x6 paper. So it does help if it comes from like the same pack, so that, you know, they blend together very well. So I'm gonna pick out 17 that I think would go together. 1. Do I have that one? Yep, I do. So we're still on 13. Sixteen. Do I have one like this one? Seven. No, I don't want that one. 18. I think I need to buy some more paper. I use a lot. 17. Then you kind of go through, if you didn't get it all from like the same paper pack and they really don't correspond, you need to go through and see what order you want them in. But it really doesn't matter, except for maybe the front and the back cover. I'm kind of liking that one for the front. 1, 2, 3. two go together. I think that'll be my back. This will be my top. So let's see, this will be our front cover, this will be our inside, this will be our pocket. It really doesn't matter ultimately, just as long as your front and your back cover. Match. Alright, you will need some way to score your papers. And you will need some glue. So for our first paper, we are going to score on the left-hand side a half an inch. Our second piece of paper, you're going to score a half an inch on the left-hand side. And this is our front cover. So we want to, are we going like that? We are going to glue it on top of that. And you want to make sure things are pretty well aligned. I mean, it's not going to be perfect. At least mine never are. And as imperfect as they are, they still work. So this, then your third page, you want to score on the right side. A half an inch. Everything will be a half an inch. here's our front. You know what? I think I just did this backwards. Let's see, because here's our third page and it's going on the right side. Because what's going to happen is we're going to glue this down. And this needed to we need to fold to the All right. Let me find a different Okay, we're going to make this journal. So you'll need 17 6x6 pieces of paper. And it doesn't really matter what order they go in, just as long as your first and your last page kind of go together, or, you know, will look good, because this piece is going to overlap on this piece just a little bit. So I've got my 17 pieces of 6x6 paper in the order that I think I want them, and then you will need something to score them with. And we are going to be scoring the first piece, we will be scoring on the left. A half an inch in. So a half an inch on the left. So this is my cover. Then your second page you're going to do on the left. Then we are going to take this page and glue it onto the inside cover of page one, like this. Now you could leave, you know, you could just glue three sides and have a pocket right there, but in this instance, we're going to glue it down, which might be the better choice at this point, but we're not gluing it down just yet. I think if you would glue, if you wouldn't glue it down, I'm thinking the two pieces together would make a stronger cover for your journal. And these do make nice little gifts. That's why I like making them. I kind of feel like that paper's a little bit bigger. All right, page three, we are going to score on the right side. Now I've already scored this one. But we'll just do it again for the sake of this video. So score it on the right. to do it, we are going to put it on this hinge here. So we're going to fold this to just shy of our hinge right here. But then we need to make a little slit right here. So where are my scissors? Not my scissors. Let me see. This is going to go right there. And then once we get this attached right here, we'll glue this whole page down. And then this one, we will glue the three sides. But get glue on that. Make sure things bend correctly. All right, now we're going to glue sheet number two all the way down onto our front. Kind of thinking this paper is just a tad bit bigger than 6x6. All right, next we are going to glue two sides. Because we want this to be a pocket. No, it got glue on it. So there we have page 1, 2, 3. Page number 4, we are going to hinge on the right side. And we're going to glue it on top of this hinge right here. make sure everything is bending the way that it should. Like this one doesn't want to bend. So make sure you're working your pages as you go. All right, page number 5. We are going to fold in half. No hinging on this one. Hold on. Gotta move a little bit of stuff. Running out of workspace. So we're folding this in half, and then we are going to glue it onto this on both sides. We're gluing it like that. So you might want to glue one side first. And then glue the other side. Make sure your things are all going smoothly. See, mine's sliding all over the place. Come on. We can do this. There's one side. And then we're going to put some glue and just glue down the other side. Making sure things are bending properly. So then we're on to page 6, which is this page, and it's going to be a pocket. So, at this point, things might be getting not quite at the half inch point. So, you may just want to start making marks on where to score. And then also on this one, we want to put a little make a little hole here for your pocket. And what did I do wrong? What did I just do wrong right there? I made my hole without scoring my paper. So now it's going to be off. So we're scoring on the right side. And it was upside down. Let me grab a different paper. Let me see if I've got another one of that one. we go. Here's one. So don't do what I just did. Score it first on the right side. Oh, I got up too early. Like, why am I on the not the colored side of the paper? I guess it really doesn't matter as long as it's the right side. So now now you can cut out your circle, your half circle, or you know, whatever. Shall we try this one more time? My TV just went off. I got a ghost in here. So this we're going to glue on three sides to create our pocket. Make sure things are straight, or as even as they can be. Alright, page number 7 will be scored on the right side. Let's see here. Telephone booth. Okay, that's the right side. And you can either put that on top or it can go under, but I think I'm going to put mine on top. Sure, things can bend. Page number 8 is going to be scored on the right side. Half an inch. And again, this can either go over the top or you can put this over the top. I'm going to go over the top and we're gluing this whole piece down. Because here's this page. And now we're creating this page. And on this one, I chose to put it over the top. So but I think I kind of like them like that. And as you can tell, mine's like, I think these pages are a little bit bigger than 6x6, actually. Okay, I'm putting mine over the top, and we're going to glue the whole thing down. Maybe that's why they put that on top, because it's easier to glue it down, but not happening. Not happening for me. I can glue it down. Come on, come on. We can do it. We can do it. Maybe that's why, because it doesn't, it's doing its own little thing right here. All right, then we glue the whole page down. I forgot what page number we're on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're on number 9. Alright, page number 9 gets scored on the right side. Gluing mine on top of my hinge, or you can, and see mine's going to be a little weird, because these were just a tad bit bigger. I should have made sure they were all 6x6s. These really, see how this isn't quite half an inch right there. So I think I will put mine on the top side of it. Look at me trying to give you a tutorial on this, and I'm messing it up. See? And see, that might be the reason why you put these on top rather than, or underneath rather than on top. While I let that dry for a minute, we will go through this. Embellishments. So this one I added a little belly band and a journaling card. Up here we have a bookmark. I didn't add any beads to that one. Usually I do. I ended up gluing this down to make a pocket. Then we come over here and I made a journaling card. And the purpose of a journaling card is to put underneath so you can write. And it could, you know, you could use it as a bookmark. So here we have a waterfall. Pages to journal on. Made a little notebook here. And we'll go through these. We will make these. Then this is a flip out. And I stamped this with a rubber stamp. This folds down too. And I made a little pocket there, a very small one. And then this up here, a journaling card. Goes in here. This flips out. I left that one blank. And then this comes out. But I really like this journal. It's cute. Very cute. All right, let's see if we're dry. See, mine is really way, way off. All right, number 10. So we're going to fold this in half because we're on to this page right here. So fold this in half. And keep us all in your prayers tomorrow. My husband goes to have a procedure done on his heart. So we are going to glue this right here. Make sure things are bending correctly. See, I might need to. There. So that one goes like that. Page 11, we're going to hinge on the right side. And once you make one, you can always look back to the one that you just made, like I'm doing. So we are going to, let me see, is this a pocket now? No, we're going to glue this one down onto the previous page. And I'm going to do it on the page. If I could stay straight on something, it would be a miracle. And let me know if you can hear me or not. I know I have a very soft voice. I can speak louder. I should speak louder. That's probably why I wasn't talking before. I couldn't talk very loud. Let me see, what page are we on now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We're on to 12. Hinge on the right side. It like so. And as you can see, mine is nowhere near perfect at all. Let me see here. Kind of, I don't know where we went wrong here. All right. The next page, we need to measure. To this edge and then trim off. Go a little bit before the edge and then we're going to trim off. And then we're going to cut our diagonal because we're making another pocket. There, maybe to about here. Let me see, I can't see my one up there. It's right there. And that's right there. Alright. And save this piece because you can use it later. Yeah. So then we glue this to this hinge. This might be where I went wrong. was gluing things on top of the hinge. And it should be. I should be going under the hinge. So now we glue two sides to create our pocket. Then, let me see, the next page. Actually, I think I got them out of order. I think I did it right. I glued my paper to my desk. I don't know how I did that. Managed to do that. 17, 16, 15, 14. Just put them in a different spot. All right, this goes on the, it says the right hand side, but we're gonna do left hand side because I done messed it up. And that's the beauty about this, you can change it up. Changing it up because this should have been this page. Instead, I've done went back to this page. So, we are going to glue this right here to the right. So, this should show you that you can actually do this any way that you want. And it should show you not to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning and start crafting. So our next page then is going to be the one that folds. So we need to measure here. And we've got to cut off a little bit. And mine just keep. See, mine is. Somehow I've gotten. I don't know. I think not all my papers were the same. Now we're pretty straight here, except for the front. So this one we have to cut over here looking for my pencil so I can make myself a little line. And I'm going to cut it a little bit smaller than what the previous page was. Because otherwise it'll get caught as you're trying to turn your pages. And then we score a half an inch at the top of this one. And then we fold. We're going to fold it in half to just shy of our score line. So this one we're going to take our tape glue like this. Let's glue on this hinge. Then our next one, we're going to hinge on the right side. And because we're going to make a, let me see, is this one going to be the pocket? See, I've really messed this one up, really, and seriously. We'll see if this makes it on as a video. I feel like I need one more page, actually. Where's that one that I messed up earlier? Maybe we'll just make a pocket there. Let's see if I can save this. don't copy this video. Go watch the video, the earlier video. And if you're like me, is this my last page? Let me see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, this is my last page. I think I want to put this there. We're going to save this. I'm going to save this project. Oh my goodness. Why am I using my last? Yeah, I done glued the wrong side. I don't need glue on that yet. Or maybe I do want to glue it. I think I want to glue this side of it. This side. Let me see. And we will glue it like this. There. We're going to glue it like this. This is going to be... Alright, I need one more piece of paper. One more piece of paper. How about this one? See, I actually need two more pieces of paper. goes like that. Gonna make this work, people. Put that there. We'll need one on the inside. Let me put this one right here. Put that one right there. Now we're going to make this one a pocket. So we got to glue this. We're going to glue this. We're going to glue this. Now I'm thinking my problem is going to be this is not going to be I'm actually going to glue this one onto that one totally. And I'm going to do it that way because this is so uneven right there. All right, let's get gluing. So really, I guess it doesn't matter. We'll see if this turns out. It won't matter how you create it. I mean, if you're worried about messing up, you can just see what I just did. And we will go back and we will see how we can correct some mistakes that I've made. So here's page 1, 2, 3. And I may glue this shut, I don't know. 4, 5. We got a pocket there. Flip out here. Pocket here, flip down here, flip out there. We've got a pocket right here. So there we have it. It's not very straight on this end. So I'll probably do another one and try and do it the correct way. But as I just said, don't be afraid to make mistakes. This whole thing is one big mistake. So I may just keep this one for myself. Anyway, thank you for being here today. As always, be safe. Don't let the world change your smile. Let your smile change the world. Bye.